The truth the grocery stores don't want you to know. My name is Jasmine Nobley, a registered dietitian, and if you're new to my channel, I share nutrition, fitness, and health content. So if you like what you see, hit the subscribe button below. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you 9 things that the grocery store doesn't want you to know. From the placement of perishable items to deals that are too good to be true, these stores have a lot of tricks up their sleeve to keep you spending more. Number 1, store layouts. Have you ever wondered why eggs and milk are located in the back of the store instead of the front? Most say it's because of the fact that they're perishable items and need to be temperature controlled. But another way to look at it is eggs and milk are perishable items and one of the first things people run out of when they're going to the grocery store. So by placing them in the back of the store, you have to walk through the aisles picking up items that you probably wouldn't have been picking up to begin with. Number 2, 10 for 10 deals. Grocery stores are full of tricks to make you think that you're saving money when you're not necessarily saving a dime. One of the most common is the 10 for 10 deal. Have you ever been walking through the grocery store and you see an item with that 10/10? While it might seem like you're getting a deal, that's not necessarily the case. I know I used to get excited when I used to see the 10 for 10 deal. The reality hit when I went to the cash register with 9 items instead of 10, and I asked her to go back to go buy a 10th item, and she said that I was gonna get the same deal anyways, 1 for $1. So don't be fooled, the 10 for 10 deals, if you look at the fine print, it'll actually say that all of those items, even if you don't buy 10, are discounted. So 1 for $1, 2 for $2, 5 for $5, whatever you want. Number 3, grocery stores tend to avoid anything that's gonna let you know what time it is. I mean, when was the last time you saw a clock in a grocery store? Probably never. So, most grocery stores have no windows or natural light. So you can't really tell what time of the day it is, if it's gotten dark out, if it's still light out. The reason behind this grocery store strategy is because they want you to stay in the grocery store for longer, buy more food, spend more money, and help their bottom line. Number 4, flowers and the bakery located at the front of the store. The flower section and the bakery are usually located on opposite ends of the grocery store. And that's not any coincidence. They're located by both entrances. So right when you walk in, you're gonna be either smelling fresh flowers and pleasant scents, or you're gonna be smelling baked goods, bakery items that are gonna trigger your hunger and typically cause you to purchase more. Some grocery stores might even pump artificial smells to get you to buy more from their bakery. Number 5, pricey items at eye level. Grocery store owners know that individuals looking to buy their groceries typically don't look too high or too low. What they're looking at is directly in front of them at eye level. So you're gonna find the most expensive items at eye level with the best deals above and below your eyesight. Number 6, placing complementary items next to each other. And although this is pretty convenient when shopping, being able to grab food items that work well together, it actually also increases the grocery store's bottom line. For example, peanut butter and jelly are typically in the bread aisle. Popcorn and movie theater candy are typically right across from each other. So you're buying the sweet and salty together. You often find barbecue sauces and spices near the meat aisle. And then, of course, you have pasta and pasta sauce right next to each other. Oh, one more. And chips and salsa, obviously. So this will encourage you to purchase more items that go together instead of them being in separate parts of the grocery store. Number 7, the checkout aisle, also known as land of the impulse buy. So grocery stores typically put things like batteries, candy, chips, small items that you can grab and go. And if you're someone going to the grocery store when you're hungry, you're gonna be more likely to buy these items. Just be mindful that these are strategically placed for you to last minute grab them. Typically they're not too high priced and they're small items, so you don't feel like you're gonna be spending a lot of money. But when you buy a lot of those little things over time, they do add up. Number 8, music. Studies show that type of music can significantly impact your spending habits. According to research, slow music can have you staying in the grocery store for longer and spending more money, while grocery stores that play classical music will have you purchasing more expensive items. Number 9, the shopping cart. Conveniently invented in 1938, was a great tool for people shopping in large amounts for their families. But if you were someone who was just going in to grab a couple of things, having a large shopping cart will likely encourage you to buy more items and spend more money. Instead, opt for the shopping basket. Or just go in with no basket at all and grab. Actually, I've done that before. It's the worst idea ever. Don't do that. Those are my 9 truths that the grocery store doesn't want you to know. If you like this content and love hearing about nutrition, fitness, and health tips from a registered dietitian, click the subscribe button below, like this video, and hit the notification bell to catch my latest videos.